Let's go.
Rookie pilot Ron Vargas is minutes away from the most difficult flying in the bush, canyon runs.
Here we go. Very good.
CeCe is watching his every move. One slip here in the mountains, and his dream of being a bush pilot in the States is over.
And then slow the airplane back down again. Slow the airplane back down again. You're busy descending. Pick up the nose. Fly against the side of updraft.
I don't know how many times I've had to tell Ron this, but he continuously keeps on putting the nose down and descending.
Your nose is pointing again down here. You've got to overcome this problem now.
When you're flying in mountainous territory, especially low level in the mountains where you don't have an horizon, when you're looking at the ground and you're looking at the face of the mountain, the tendency is to descend the whole time, and it could result in a dive or a spiral dive. And you cannot do that in a narrow canyon because you're going to crash, bottom line.
I'm not happy with it.
Okay.
You're tensing up. You must relax. All right. I'm going to have you give me another canyon turn now. Back into the canyon.
Right.
Let's go. Canyon turn. Go. Keep the turn going. Is the halfway mark? Look at the tightness of that turn. Very good. Big improvement since earlier today. Well done. That was much better.
Yeah, that was a lot better.
A lot better. All right, that's the end of this exercise.
Okay.
It's going to take a little bit more polishing up, but we'll get there. Just remember the airspeed, okay, and altitude.
Okay.
Canyon flying was pretty challenging, but after the second try, I knocked it out. So I was really stoked about that.
Okay, so we're about, what, half an hour from sunset right now?
It's late.
Okay, let's head back to base. So in a few minutes, it's going to be dark.
Okay.
Flying at night, really, it's really kind of overwhelming if you think about it. There's no control towers. So the danger level just increases one, two, three, four, fourfold.
What's your altitude? Danger failure. Okay, I want you to get the airplane down. That area down there, see it?
I see it.
I want you to land on that strip down there.
Okay.
Pick up the nose. All right, there's the runway overhead. You see it?
I see it.
Okay, turn. Come on, you must think clearly now. Wings level. Get it down.
Not bad. Well done.
Oh man, that'll rattle your spine.
The moment we touched down, I was really laughing at this thing. I mean, I never expected him to pull this off.
That was good. Well done.
Thank you.
The engine failure.
That had me freaked. It literally freaked out. I can't believe I made it. You know, that's a scary situation.
Hectic.
Oh, that was crazy.
Ron doesn't know. I cut the engine on him. I wanted to see if he can handle that situation. And he did a good job of the landing, I must say. Very impressed with that.
The engine failure was a test. Just one example of why this is one of the toughest courses in the world. But the mission is nowhere near over.
This is a training exercise. I have created a problem on the engine. That's why you had to land.
Okay.
The sun is busy going down.
Oh.
We're not going to have time to fix this engine right now and fly out of here.
Okay.
Okay, so what are we going to do? Survival, what are we going to do?
CeCe keeps challenging me with different scenarios. Just keeps getting harder and harder. The training here is pretty extensive.
Yeah, we are in the middle of nowhere. And you don't know if we've got enough to survive the night. Always expect the unexpected. Bush flying is a lot more than just flying the aircraft. You must always think of the possibility that something could go wrong. If it doesn't, you have to land somewhere and you have to overnight. Always carry sufficient survival equipment. Go have a look in the back of the aircraft and tell me what you see there.
Okay. All right.
We've got our tools, we've got water, we've got enough rations, we've got survival gear. we've got firearms. Didn't think about that, did you?
No, I didn't.
He wants to become a bush pilot. So he's responsible for not only his own life, but the life of his passengers. When it hasn't happened to you yet, you don't think about it.
Every flight treated as a survival flight.
Okay, so right now, let's get our gear out the plane, set up camp.
There's wild animals out there. It's just like, what did I get myself into?
In South Africa, Rookie Ron is getting his first taste of the wild side of bush flying. Survival.
Got some decent wood.
Water.
That I wouldn't do. You're wasting our drinking our survival water on the ground.
I just want to make sure that...
Bad mistake.
Well, I just used it so that way...
No, don't do it. We've got a fire extinguisher. That's survival. Water, okay. You do not waste under any... So you can on it if you want to, but don't use your drinking water. That's it. I mean, I'll on it. Yeah. All right. You got a lighter?
No? I was planning on using matches.
Have you got matches?
Not on me.
Well, luckily I brought some.
Good.
Some matches.
Okay.
You want to put some avgas on it? Get the fuel tester, get some avgas.
Just a little bit, okay.
Yeah, we don't have to rub sticks together out here. We've got lots of fuel in the aircraft. Let's just go get a teaspoon. That'll do it. Okay. Guess what? Packed a bottle of wine.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Good day.
Good day. Is CC your nickname or is that your real name?
That's my nickname. People call me Captain Crash because I've had so many aircraft crashes over the years. Not lately. Nobody taught me anything about bush flying or anything. I taught myself.
Oh, okay.
And I learned the hard way. I've written off a few aircraft in environments that most pilots would not be alive.
Wow.
And it's the accidents that I've had which actually led me to start this training.
Oh, okay.
So I realized that I've survived some very serious and a lot of pilots are dying because they're making mistakes. They don't know how to do it safely. So here I am teaching people like you how to do it the right way.
Okay.
Not the hard way. That's the difference. That's it, let's call it a night. We've got to get turning quite early so we can get up early in the morning.
CC, even though we're sharing this moment together here, when we crash out tonight, no spooning.
No forking either.